Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to my channel and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. We're gonna start from Aspire 1 VR. Some of you tuned in to my live stream yesterday. For those of you who didn't watch, we've got Tales of Two Games when it comes to Aspire 1 VR, an excellent PC version and PSVR port which is below average. Now, what's happened with this game? I'm not reviewing it yet because the developers promised patch to come very, very soon. I'm gonna speak about it in a minute. But first of all, I want to talk about the problems that Aspire 1's got, and I would maybe advise you to wait for a patch before you buy this game, because what's happening at the moment with PSVR version, it's running at super low resolution, there is no aliasing at all. For some reason, some areas of the game getting super dark that you cannot see. Also, it's got those random loading screens, abduction style, when you just walk in and suddenly you get in little mini loading screen. But apart from bad graphics and forced click turning and also forced tunnel vision, which apparently is just a mistake and those options should be there soon, the game is really full of bugs, the things not working properly, the ragdoll effects, the enemies can bounce all over the place. Even the AI, I've had moment when I pretty much stood right in front of enemy and he didn't reacted. The bodies, when you kill them, you cannot even move them around. You can touch them, but they won't move. The voice commands don't working. You've got cases of disappearing hands, or you've got cases of hands that appear and they both rendered together with move controllers, which is looks very odd. Also, reloading not always work. You're supposed to just swipe your hand across the belt and it's supposed to reload your weapon. Something what Apex Cybernetic does, but in this game it's hard to get it work. Movement wise, I've been getting stuck in environment. I can't count how many times I was on top of ladder or something and just fell to the bottom again and I didn't even know why. Objective markers are not working on PlayStation VR version, and all in all, there is so many options missing. You cannot readjust your belt once you do it once. The bullets just look like little tiny white dots. You cannot even see text properly, so you cannot read properly. The textures not always loading. Most of the time they're not loading properly. So we've got those Nintendo 64 type textures. So like I said, wait for a patch. What happened is the developers said today that they outsourced PSVR port. They work on the PC version, which is really nice game. Really, it works great, so you know, just keep that in mind. But also they work on Quest port, which looks better than PSVR, which is baffling because of course Quest is not as powerful. Not dissing the Quest, by the way, because it's amazing piece of hardware. I'm just saying the PSVR port, it's not been done by them apparently. It's been done by external dev, and apparently somebody somewhere fucked up. Now who? And when, I don't know, if you've got, you know, load the developers working on the game, you've got Tripwire publisher and you've got this external developer as well, to somebody actually played PSVR version. What's going on here? Because at the moment, this game, the game that I was super hyped for, it's pretty bad. I don't know if it's, you know, maybe I'm too upset about it, because many times I said it's my most anticipated game of this year. So when I played PSVR version, I was like, oh no, what is this? This is not the game I was promised. The developer said the gameplay gonna be one-to-one representative to the PC version, and they showed PC version so many times, and it looks so good, and the gameplay on PSVR is just not like it, because the is so many things not working at the moment. But saying that, they announced today that they will be having patch soon. They be working on it very hard and they're gonna have it as soon as possible, because PSVR is the important platform for them. But somehow, somewhere, this game got released in that state, and after so many delays and after so much hype for PSVR owners, sadly this game as it is now, I say just stay away for now, wait for patch, see what people gonna think. If you read reviews, keep in mind that they are done on PC VR version. So from PC you're gonna get great scores. So if they're gonna manage to patch the game and manage to get it to the PC level, I don't even want super spunky awesome graphics. I'm just talking about the gameplay itself. If they manage to do that, then I'd be happy and I'm taking. But like I said at the beginning of this video, at the moment is a tale of two games. The one great game on PC and a very, very poor port on PlayStation VR. So wait for a patch. What I want to say is they announced they're gonna be working hard on it and it should be coming in near future. Okay, next story. Contagion VR developers announced today that they're planning to have the game out in Europe on 27th. So only 5 days away. Now they're saying this is the date they should. For if something goes wrong, it might change, but this is the date they want. So let's hope everything goes right. As we know, Europe, when it comes to the European store and all the European ratings and all that stuff, it is more difficult and more expensive for the developers, so I think that's why there was delay, but they said they shoot in for next week. Also, they already announced the next mission, which is gonna be their biggest and best ones. Also, this game had a bit of trouble start, but pretty much 2 days after, all the issues was fixed. And if you cannot wait for Contagion and you couldn't play it because it wasn't out anywhere outside the America, then you should be lucky because this game should be out in Europe soon. Okay, next story. Speaking about release date, Saber developers announced that European release gonna be on 18th of December. There will be big patch in works, but already they put out little patch which add in the flat version support from this game. So if you got it from US, that's supported now. And also what they worked on, they improved matchmaking in the game. When the game releases in Europe, you'll be able to play solo or with other player. They will add new controls and will allow proper strafing for DualShock 4 while keeping the moves as intuitive as they was. This list is pretty huge and this is a game that kind of got overlooked, but with this release what they gonna do now, you could call it Saber 2.0. And keep in mind that Saber might not been the most popular because it was online only and only released to US, so it had limited market on PlayStation VR and released to even more limited market because it only came out in US, but it's not a bad game. It's very fun to play, so if you missed it, just wait for European release. There will be influx of players, but also there will be solo mode as well, so you'll be able to play just by yourself. Okay, next story. VR Ping Pong Pro is a ping pong game which lately released and many people had problems with it because it didn't actually play as good as proper ping pong did. Now the developers already released some patches on Steam and trying to make the game better, but they announced that the patches will be coming to PlayStation 4 version as well. But what they doing, instead of releasing small patches, they gonna release one big patch. So the physics should get improved and overall the gameplay of the game itself, it should be less frustrating than it is now. I know this game you can learn because I learned it for the review, but also you not learning as you playing maybe proper ping pong, but you trying to learn what to play the ping pong VR game, which got somehow different physics than real life. That's how I come across to it. So I gonna wait with my review yet again to this big patch to drop for PlayStation 4. But if you picked it up and kind of got frustrated, just keep in mind that the developers was listening. They already updated the game on Steam, but on PSVR it will be one big patch and the game should work better. Okay, and something I want to talk about is No Man's Sky Beyond. We've got this game in VR, it's awesome, but it's blurry, we've been paying for this pro patch. Now, is it coming? Is it not? It's not 100% confirmed, but it looks like it probably is. Because their next update seem to be a very nice, big, juicy update. And I can tell that because they named this update. Every time they give name to the update for No Man's Sky, it means something big is about to happen. The update is called Synthesis and basically what they said, it's gonna address all the most requested community issues. And I think from all the issues that was really requested, the PS4 Pro owners was very, very vocal about it because they want this game to run with a proper PlayStation 4 Pro support, proper Pro optimization. So it looks like that might be addressed. Like I said, they didn't say 100% is PlayStation 4 Pro patch, but they said everything what community wanted will be addressed in this update. And as you can see, it's got a name. The name in the update means good things. Now, No Man's Sky is great. I really like this game. Many people playing it, you know, you get used to those graphics, those blurry graphics. Especially that the game works nicely anyway and gameplay is super fun, so people just enjoying it. But looking past it, it would be nice to have even better, proper, sharp graphics on PlayStation 4 Pro. Because let's don't this PlayStation 4 Pro. This is quite powerful hardware. Maybe it's got its limitations, but the most limitations in No Man's Sky coming from base PS4 and they translate to Pro because there's no Pro optimizations. So once the developer Hello Games includes those in No Man's Sky, I can see this game looking much, much better than it is now. But of course, probably still we play the same. And the gameplay is super fun. Of course, the biggest VR game ever released, you can say. Infinite amount of game. And to pull it off on, you know, VR, especially on PS4 original, it's an amazing, amazing technical achievement. So Hello Games, even though we do like to moan about our games, especially with Pro because we want better better graphics, Hello Games still managed to pull something exceptional and something what keeps community really engaged, because people just can play No Man's Sky all the time and that can be only game they gonna play in VR. Of course, stay tuned to the channel, because once I know more about SynthFZ's update, then for sure I will let you know. Okay, I'm trying to wrap up this video and I just realized it's been full of me talking about the patches. Is that becoming a norm now? Release a game and then try to patch shit out of it before people lose their shit. I don't know what's happened lately with PSVR, but what I seem to talk about is just patches, patches, patches. Let's hope this will change in the future, but let me know what you think. Let me know what you think about Aspyr 1 VR. Did you pick it up and what you think of it? Or are you going to wait for the patch, and what you think about this PlayStation VR port? And of course, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.